Hello guys, feel very welcome to Usitility. Today is special, we are on the way to discover how to run Dune's Journey Hidden Objects on PC. Here you're watching it on your screen. It takes almost no time to easily download and set up Dune's Journey Hidden Objects so that we can play your game on a Windows desktop or laptop with gamer keyboard if we want to, mouse and big screen. So it's time to have fun, let's get to it. First of all my friends, the first thing to do is to launch our main browser. We have here the one we prefer. Let's go to that URL that I have highlighted in green color. Now, you are able to see on the screen. You don't need to type it, simply because there's the clickable link in the video description and as well in the first pinned comment. We landed on this page on the internet site of Usitility, in which we find here a precise description on how to download Dune's Journey Hidden Objects on personal computer. We scroll lower a little bit and mouse click on the Download Game on PC button. After clicking on that link, we reach the site of BlueStacks. No panic, it is only the Android emulator that we are going to use to get access to the game Dune's Journey Hidden Objects on PC. As you can see from here, we have several pros of using that emulator. Now we are on the way to proceed to download the Dune's Journey Hidden Objects by simply clicking on this button play on BlueStacks that I have marked in green. Next step is clicking on it. And the download starts and ends immediately. Voila, here is located the download. It is an executable file. What we are going to do now is to launch the executable file, so we click on the file. If we are on Windows 10, it will have asked us for permission to allow changes to the system. We click yes. I minimize the web browser to view the installation software significantly better. The installer is straightforward. It includes a couple of choices, install and setup path. I will describe what setup path does. We simply click on it. And we discover that we have now here the path where in fact the emulator is going to be set up. If we would like to change this directory, we must click on that Browse button. Therefore we opt for another directory and set up the emulator specifically where we desire. I prefer to keep it where it is. I click on Back, and I pick Install. Now, there it is. The install begins and it is going to commence in the download of those megabytes that are shown on this screen. The moment you save it on your machine, it may be a bit more or less MB. The data transfer speed will go at a higher speed or at a lower speed, depending on your type of access to the web and depending on the performance of the emulator hosting servers. Now they're going extremely fast. The download has been completed, so at this point it continues on with the setup procedure. The installation will take more or less time depending on the strength of your computer. The more efficient it's actually, the shorter the software installation time and or vice versa. If we join the download and software installation step, it might take quite a long time, so show patience. It has by now completely finished on my side. Now, the emulator has actually been launched on autopilot. As you can see, at the bottom of the screen, there's a progress bar which will fill up and once it actually reaches the end, the emulator will be launched for the first time. In fact, the emulator is already launched, there for the first time. Before we continue, as you understand, it made a couple of software icons there on the PC desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks icon is the one we're interested in. At any time when we would like to run Dune's Journey Hidden Objects on the laptop or computer, we double mouse click on this specific app icon and run the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon has nothing to do with multiplayer or even nearly anything like this. In reality, it is an icon that we might most likely never ever utilize. Let's make the following step, which is actually a requirement, and this is to begin browsing the Google Play Store. As you can see, the Google Play is presented. There we have got to log on. Now the moment we are right here, we must definitely execute the next step which is mandatory. So that we click on Sign In. Now it announces checking info. It may occasionally get blocked in checking info, that's why it doesn't move forward. If so, you should try to connect to your account after a couple of hours, it's going to most likely be fixed. Now we shall type in our username and password. The email address needs to be a Gmail email and its corresponding password. As an example, you can use the same exact email you are using currently in your own YouTube account. Therefore I will type my info and I will go back when I have completed it. That's it, information inserted. Find out Google welcoming us and supplying us their terms of service. We are going to accept them by simply clicking on I agree. Next, it allow us to back up to the Google Cloud. You might let it selected and it'll create a backup of the data files on this device to Google Drive. I am not going to select it, you do what you want. We just click on accept. Google Play is started automatically and on autopilot. To set up the application, we must go to the emulator desktop by clicking on the icon indicated green colored. Now that we are exploring the desktop of this emulator for Android, we notice that we find right here the install game button. We click on this button. Here we access to the video game. How about we just click now on the install option that I'm highlighting now in green. and it will initiate the setup. Right now it would download and install the game, it may take a while or perhaps it could be almost immediate. It again all depends on our own internet access. It's just completed setting up. Now, let's go to the emulator desktop by simply clicking on that option that I'm emphasizing in green, so that you can launch June's Journey Hidden Objects for the first time. Let's press on that My Games Choice Proceeding. We are at present on the emulator desktop, and consequently we are preparing to just click that new June's Journey Hidden Objects icon that has been provided. The Android game is launched for the first time. So there we end up with it. I could click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I will talk about the volume level of that emulator. It's right here. We have got the icon of higher volume and the icon of lower volume. This way we will not count on the Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound experience of your emulator. And to appreciate the experience to the max, we should switch on the large monitor, for which we have two options. This is simply the first one. We mouse click on this particular app icon that I'm pointing out in green. And the display screen is maximized, coming with one border on top, one at the right and one at the bottom. If we aspire to experience the app using all the screen, we mouse click on this particular icon. And we would probably by now be experiencing and enjoying the Android game in 100% screen setting. To exit the full screen mode, hit the F11 key. And we would undoubtedly at present play in regular display screen mode. Now I am ready to present you the keys mapping that is certainly quite appealing. This way we will probably be able to play the game application more effortlessly. The first point is to press this application icon. It's now time to get the appropriate controls. I'll go ahead and keep the default configuration, but if you require to change this, you may very well do it without having problem. Perhaps you have realized, the emulator is absolutely in our language. In certain cases it occurs that your emulator is started in the wrong language, for example, in Chinese. And to set it up in the correct language we browse here to the cogwheel. And right here inside of various other controls, we just click that language drop down. We may decide on the language we want, English, Mandarin, etc. As soon as the language is determined, we would save, the emulator will reboot, along with the Android game, next time we start it, would of course be in the opted for language. Now, you will find another element that we need to take into consideration, and this is that we will receive a message from Gmail saying that a new equipment has been connected to this Google account. It will likely ask us if we're the individuals who have connected that electronic device. Absolutely, we really should not worry, considering the fact that emulator is simulating an Android tablet or smartphone. And to identify which electronic device is currently being emulated, we go right here, to the cogwheel and we click on it. And we browse here to the model choice. And there we observe that the emulator is simulating a Samsung cellular phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all guys, so much for this video tutorial. I sincerely hope you appreciated it, particularly that you found it useful. If that's so, give it a pleasant thumb up, subscribe, and if you have feedback, concerns or ideas, let them in the comment area below. You could possibly also comment things on my Twitch channel, I perform live streams occasionally, you get it listed below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Simply click on any of these training videos which are usually appearing on the screen and let's have fun again in the upcoming video game videos. Bye.